All right, roller paint job. Let's get it. Thank you.
part. It's been almost 17 minutes. And you can see it's got some bubbles in it. Also, you can come, well, you can come over them and knock them down a little bit. Also, you don't want to leave any type of drips for too long. So, yeah, don't put the paint on so thick so that you get drips. And if you do get some, or lines, you know, if you get some lines, then try to go over them like I'm doing right here. If you were more patient than me, you could do more coats and maybe it would come out better. I don't know. But, you know, if you do this, you'll get the hang of it. Most likely you're not doing it on some type of $1 million Ferrari or anything. It's probably just a $500 car or something, multicolored, rat rod, or some project like this one. So I highly recommend it. I'm not even done yet, but it's highly recommended, you know. Definitely. You could get even cheaper paint than I did, probably. That looks much better. Of course, I need to give it a few coats. So, yeah, I hate when people paint their cars. Yeah, I don't like when people paint their cars and they just do like one coat and it's like this. Nah, at least we're gonna have, it's gonna be a solid coat all the way around. And hopefully I'll put enough on it to where I'll be able to wet sand it or do some type of buffing or something. Anyway, Mike, I'm out here, let's get it.
Got this, we're gonna paint over this right there. Do you see it? I see it. I'll get a close up for this. They're painting right over that. Alright, that looks good. Let's go. That thing looks like it just absorbed a bunch of paint. I don't know where that's going. I might stay away from the lock a little bit because I feel like I could do a better job taping it. No primer on this door. I don't know. It'll be fine. Oh, that's how you fix that. Ooh. Sparkly. Try again. If at first you don't succeed. You know what I'm saying? They want to give me a fight there, whatever that is. There's a rest. Say goodbye to the rest. No. Go on. It doesn't really matter which way you go, probably. What's going on here? The other door didn't do that. Yeah, we're being sloppy. Get rid of that primer gray spot. The wrong color. Nice down there. Look at that spot. Don't look at that spot. Thank you. Ooh. I don't like that. Alright, just taking a lot of paint back right now. We're just smoothing it out, getting rid of a lot of these bubbles. I don't really know. I'm not an expert at this. Definitely this is the first time I've roller painted a car. So yeah, I'm just learning as I go along. Or I don't even know if I've learned yet. I'm just going along here. Maybe you can learn from me. I say do it though, no matter what. Like that right there is taking, it's taking the bubbles away, but it's also like taking some of the glossy shine away. But that's okay, because we're gonna see, this one had primer underneath it, so that might have been helping some, but who knows. I think you might want to clean it up like that a little bit. I definitely didn't do that everywhere, I don't think. It looks good. Does. I want to use all this paint. I don't know where it can go. I should try to stretch and get the middle part, but I kind of need a break right now, so I'm about to just, there's probably going to be one gray part left. Yes. Yeah, so I'm definitely not doing this in any type of, I don't know, I'm not being careful really, what I'm trying to say. I'm just putting the paint on, but yeah, definitely don't let it, if you're using anything like I'm using, don't let it dry too quickly without smoothing it out, son, because it will do that. Oop, more rust bubbles. Yes. You know what to do with those. That's a lot of paint right there. Alright. It's almost completely painted. I'm gonna have to get a brush for some of the tight spots. Mm-hmm. There's gonna be one spot left. This is called strategy. No, it's not, just in case you were wondering. See, even that little spot, I wanted to dry real quick. Oh, I mean, that's okay, but I wasn't really trying to go over the other side there. Oh well. Yep, I see it. Dang, I thought the camera was gonna be off. I see it. Look at the sign. Dang. We're getting there so close. I feel like I got to reach for it. Go for it. I can't do it. That's a big hood. There may be some drip marks or some lines. There's not really much I could do about it. Like that. Not much I could do, except for try to not do it, but I can't really see anything anymore. I can only reach so far. I think it looks good. Alright, the paint's almost gone, that's good. There it is. Get it on the side a little. And it takes a little while to figure things out. Okay. Could have used that move like 2 days ago. Okay. That's a hard area to get right there. I don't know if we're recording anymore, but I'm still painting. Mike, I'm out here. Let's get it. It's only been 42 minutes. The battery's about to go out. My car is painted. Final touches. I didn't clean the mirror at all, really. I didn't do the other mirror either. I didn't do this part either. It's kind of difficult to get that part. I only got the middle of it at least. That part needs more. Just gonna get what's left off this brush right now. Right there. Just a little bit. Uh-oh. That move. Oh, I like that move right there. Watch out for the chrome. I see it. I didn't even get the top on this go around. Well, we got more paint. Don't you worry about that. Mike, I'm out here. Yeah. That's a Caprice. That's got paint on it. It's all one color. Hold on. This is the.
Alright, that's how paint's supposed to smell. One coat looks way better. It's gonna get more, and it's gonna get way better. I painted over that. It still needs some more. This looks like my old quarter panel. A lot of Caprices look like this because the stuff in the inside goes from side to side and bangs on the quarter panel. I missed a spot. I missed a few spots. But yeah, it looks way better. Yeah, the second coat is where you really get the coverage going. And then I'm gonna have like half a can of paint. And anytime I see a spot that needs coverage, just getting it. And then when I just feel like putting on extra, or when I feel like it's getting dull, it's getting more. You know what I'm saying? I'm putting it on. Yeah. Now I'm just focusing on spots like this. Like, this looks bad. But what about how it looked like an hour ago? It's got a lot better. So that's the story of this car, is it always gets better. And it always needs work. And there's a few spots that are kind of hard to get to. I didn't feel like I cleaned. Well, I guess I did. It just didn't look clean. So next go around, we'll get up on here into there at least. I'm not taking the bumper off. I'm not taking the grill off. This part's gonna stay gray for a while. Point it out when you see me. Woo, it's got bright here. You feel me? It ain't never shined like that before. Mike, I'm out here, let's get it. That thing ain't never shined like that before. It's been a long time. So yeah, I wanted to get out here before the sun got crazy. So now to get a chance to dry, because you know the sun at the certain point, it's almost about to be like 11:30 or so, around noon. This is gonna be too bright to even paint. I'm not gonna even be able to see what's going on. So that's pretty much what I've been doing, just like a hour a day on it. This is like the third day. Yep, so we'll be back.